our First Nation population is aging, and we're relatively young, so we're about 7 years less than the Canadian population as a whole. But we are aging, and you know, research shows and statistics show that the population age 55 and over is going to double. So with that aging trends in an aging population, we have higher rates of chronic and terminal disease, so things like cancer and heart disease. Diabetes is considered an epidemic in First Nation communities. We have very high rates of diabetes and tuberculosis. And I think people deserve excellent palliative care to relieve them from all the suffering. And for the most part, I would say that First Nation people want that opportunity and those choices to be able to die in their home communities, to be cared by their family and friends. But right now, palliative care, is not a really formalized program in First Nation communities. I think advocating and advocacy is a big piece when it comes to First Nation communities. I think because we as First Nation people have been told for so long that we need to rely on external resources, we need to rely on those individuals to speak for us. And I think it's all about regaining that voice again, and being strong and comfortable and trusting your feelings and knowing what you need to do to move forward in it. And I know that can be very challenging, and especially in the healthcare system, going up against, you know, what physicians or nurses or people external to your community are kind of telling you throughout that process. But I think it's really about finding those systems, finding those individuals who can help you move forward. When you're looking at, you know, finding those services or finding those people that can help individuals within the healthcare system or within, you know, in general, it's all about empowerment and feeling more confident in what you can and can't do. And I think it's a difficult thing, but it's not impossible. And I think the younger generation now, through education and through being advocates for our own people, we're coming out. But I think it's going to take more. I'm always so encouraged when I see another First Nations person who is interested in doing research, because I'm a firm believer that research, in order for it to be done in the best way possible, should be done by our own people. And so whenever I see a young First Nations researcher, I get very excited, because it's about that mentoring and wanting to give them those tools so that they can move it forward. And I think it's the same thing with families. When you see a family who's struggling at the end of life, when they're caring for somebody in their families, it's a really difficult process. And nobody needs that extra burden or that extra weight put on them. They need to be fully supported. So I think they need to go out there, and I think they need to advocate for the individual that they're caring for.